So picking the right platform when you're just getting started as a streamer, it's important, as it really determines what pace you grow and what kind of success you create for yourself. And with all the tools now available, even as a console streamer, you now have access to stream to more than just Twitch, should you choose so. So before we dive in, let me know in the comments if you stream directly from your console or if you're using a streaming PC, as this is gonna help me tailor my videos in the future. So let's go ahead and kick off with Twitch, right? What are the good things about it? What are the bad things about it? And should you stream on it, right? So when you look at the good things about it, Twitch has been the OG, right? They understand what it is to go ahead and create engagement, to get people to spend money, to be able to have your viewers feel like they're part of your tribe. But the only issue is that growing that community is the challenge. Why? Because if you're a new streamer and you're coming onto Twitch and you have zero audience, zero presence, you're gonna be streaming to 0 to 1 viewers for a long time, especially if you don't know how to create content that brings people to your stream. So that's the aha moment of like, it's not the best platform for a new streamer because you're not gonna see the growth at the rate that you ultimately want to achieve. So is it a platform that I recommend for new streamers? No. Does it have some benefits and positives that ultimately are great if you do have an audience? Yes. Like, I have an audience. If I decide to stream on Twitch, I can have a group of people that come from my YouTube channel, from my social media to Twitch, that gives me a boost in the ranking, allowing me to be able to attract new viewers that are already on the Twitch platform. But if that's not the position you're in, it's not the platform you should go ahead and get started with. Then we look at Facebook, right? What are the goods and the bads, and should you be streaming on Facebook as a new streamer? Well, Facebook has a lot more features for building community. It allows you to be able to stream on there, create content, build a group, and engage with other streamers and engage with other family members and friends. The only downfall from Facebook is the fact of the experience that you have on there, right? It's not really built for a gaming community, even though they have a gaming sector, right? You have a lot of friends and family on there, which you may not want to interact with. There's just a lot of things that come in with Facebook, where it's also a platform where you typically have to like pay to play. Right? So if you know how to spend money and you know how to run advertisement and you know how to go ahead and create content on Facebook and create that engagement, then it could be a platform that could work for you. But again, is it a platform that I would recommend for new streamers? No. Now we look at YouTube, right? When you look at YouTube, what is it that YouTube offers that the other platforms don't offer, right? And it's the opportunity to be able to have your content be found today, tomorrow, the next day, next year. So it gives you the opportunity to be able to continue to be found, right? Now you say, well, Curry, I can make content on YouTube and stream on Twitch. Yes, that is right. But think about this, right? If you build an audience on YouTube, do you think that they want to move over to Facebook? You think they want to move over to Twitch, right? People want to stay on the platform that they spend the most time on. So if I'm someone that watches content on YouTube and then you stream on YouTube, guess what happens? I'm more likely to go ahead and not only subscribe to your channel, turn the notification on, but you're going to see more growth, right? So as a new streamer, where I recommend, even though it's the most challenging out of all three, from setup to distribution, to just creating content, to understanding the platform, by far the most difficult one, right? But who said the streaming journey was overnight success, right? This is a long-term journey. So if I'm talking about the long-term and where you're gonna see the most rewards and where you're gonna develop the most skills that not only are gonna help you income-wise, but also in building a community and understanding what it takes to actually build the stream business, is YouTube, right? Because ultimately what happens is that you're going to be live streaming on YouTube, right? And then you take that content, you can put it on your channel, people are able to continue to watch it, continue to get found, you can break up those clips, put them on TikTok, put them on Instagram, put them on Snapchat. It just gives you more availability and more opportunity than you ultimately have on Twitch or Facebook. Now you may say, yo, Curry, I'm a console streamer, but that's totally fine. I have a video showing you how to go ahead and stream to YouTube directly from your console. So if you stream directly from your console, go ahead and watch this video right here where I show you how to stream to YouTube directly from your Xbox. And if you stream from a PC, go ahead and watch this video right here where I show you how to live stream to YouTube using OBS. I'll see you guys in the next video. And as always, remember, together we all can thrive.